So, a very different wild camp today. I am, you'll notice, walking down a street close to my home on my way to the bus. I'm then going to get a bus to the train station and a train close to where I'll be camping tonight. So it's a public transport job. Let's see how it goes. Well, that was an uneventful journey really. Had to get the bus to Dewsbury because the one from Ossett to Wakefield had been cancelled. There were a couple of kids causing havoc as usual in the Ossett bus station, which is a great shame. Straight through to Manchester. Because of the delay at Dewsbury, missed the connection, so I had to wait 35 minutes at Manchester for the connection through to Sheffield. Much better train than the one I remember. Certainly not the very best kind of train, but lots of facilities, ran efficiently, wasn't too crowded, and I've made it to Edale. Just set off at the start of the Pennine Way. It is a beautiful day.
So today we are starting at Edale Station, walking up into Edale, starting on the Pennine Way, walking through the Edale Vale until we get to Jacob's Ladder.
Pennine Way is magnificent. I seem to be doing quite a bit of walking on it just recently. Penny Ghent's on there, Blackstone Edge is up there, Widdup Reservoir is up there, they're all my recent camps, and Kinder Scout, where we're heading today, is part of it. My first memory of the Pennine Way was just after I finished my A-levels, and there was a lad called Tiny who was huge, 6'6" easily when he was 18. He lived quite close to where I lived, and coincidentally we both went to the same church because I used to go to church then. He, as soon as he finished his A-levels, instead of taking a gap year, he decided, right, he wanted to do the Pennine Way. And him and a couple of other mates set off from Edale, doing the Pennine Way. The weather was quite bad. I seem to remember there was snow on the ground. So I suppose that puts it into a different part of the year than just straight after we finished our A-levels. And the news came through that he was missing, which was awful and extremely worrying, and they sent a search party out. He'd become detached from the couple of lads he was walking with, and they found him at the bottom of an uncapped mine shaft. Very deep, I seem to remember hundreds of feet being mentioned. There was also talk that he didn't die straight away. Now, knowing what I know now about the Pennine Way, I suspect it was just a shaft, a pothole, rather than an uncapped mine shaft, which sounds very irresponsible. Although the mines are so old that the tops rot through. My thoughts are certainly with Tiny, and from that time today. And when I crack a beer later on, I should be thinking of Tiny and of those times. Well, I'm not kidding. That has been a bugger. But we're just about there now. Just seen three guys yomping it up quite quick. They've come from Edale, so they're about 6k, and they say they're going to do 32 today. Oof. And then another lad is just passed me, running up. He's on 4k and he's going to do 16. But the hill's done now. It's steady. It's just up and down a little bit now, so that's all right. Well, I got to the top. First place I could find on Kindle, though, is where I'm going to pitch. It's not far off the path, just round the corner, and there's a lady with three youngish kids around the corner, so she don't mind me pitching reasonably close to me. In fact, she's glad, so that's nice. Well, got pitched. It's by no means perfect. It's on a slope, which I aren't really bothered about. I've got a view straight down the Edale Valley. I am yards from the footpath, which I know you're not meant to be, but I can't see many people disturbing me. Different approach to the organisation this time. I've got bags marked with all of the various bits. That's probably the most important one, because I'm going to have a go at cooking something. So we'll see how that gets on. I've got my raincoat on for the moment because it's just started spitting, but I don't think that's going to last for very long. But we have a beer review. Here we have the Brew York Salted Caramel Tong Coco. Salted caramel, coconut, cocoa, Tonka and Vanilla Imperial Milk Stout, and it's a 12%. So let's see how this goes down. I like a strong one to start off with. Called in at Beer House earlier, as you saw, to get this little baby. I don't know whether it's the Tonkoka or the cocoa, cocoa. Certainly get coconut, salted caramel. Not sure on that one. So, to absent friends, to Tiny and his family, I hope you recovered all those years ago from that tragedy. And to missing friends, both through circumstance and because they're no longer here. Got the rain battering on the tent. It's all there. I think it's pretty secure here. We're under a rock. It's quite windy, blowing a fair bit. Well, from what I've my experience. But it's great. Upping my food game today. brought my stainless steel frying pan from my other camping set. Got some milk, some olive oil, got this lovely open L chopping knife which you'll see later. There is some turkey in there which I froze and then put into my bag, and that frozen turkey has kept everything else fresh, hopefully. It's still very cold, it's not frozen now, but by no means has that had any chance to go nasty. In there I've got a half a bell pepper, some sprouting broccoli, there's an onion in there, and I've got some black bean sauce. So we shall get ourselves a little feast. And here we have the morning surprise. I won't be doing that now, but I'll be going through this little baby in the morning. I know it's quite dark, but just wanted to record. A fantastic sound. It's raining. Not too bad. It's good to get your tent up and everything inside and set up, and then it starts to teach you about homely values. Good morning. Not a bad night's sleep. I was warm enough. The noise of the wind on the tent was a bit annoying. But the thing that kept waking me up was we are on the flight path for one of the airports. And huge planes going over, making a racket, woke me up a few times, two or three times. Just had a quick look out and having missed, of course. So I'm not going to get a sunrise. I'm just going to have a quick doze. And then I will make breakfast. I do coffee and things. Which would be good. Got these Rab gloves, and I had those on last night. Do you know what a winner? I never actually thought I'd wear gloves in bed, but having your hands at a decent temperature. That is pretty good.
Still looking quite bleak out there. Just seeing a glimmer of light from over the ridge near the far side.
And morning has broken. Look at that for a beautiful outlook. Wowza. Quite like this little Uppinell knife. It is extremely sharp and you can fold it away, which is great. It also has a revolving collar there so you can lock it open. But I didn't need to use that. Using my Uko fork spoon, which I really like because it splits into a knife, fork and spoon, and then fits down into quite a small package. The one that came with the Decathlon cooking set is great as well because it collapses. What I do need, I think, is a little spatula if I'm going to be cooking in a pan. Explain my packing process. So because everything down at this side of this end of the tent, and all my bags are labelled. What I do is I pack my cookware set down, because that goes into small containers, and then I pack into each one of the bags, and as it's packed I move it to this end of the tent where I've got my bag at the moment, and then when I've gone through the whole process and moved it all about, I move my bag to this end of the tent and then pack the bags into it. Works very well. Another thing I think works very well, I don't really appreciate it until you realise you're not sat on it, is this foil mat. I haven't got a very expensive air mat. I think it was about 30 quid. It's got no insulation value at all. It adds some comfort. So putting this underneath it gives me the insulation from the floor, and certainly last night that was ample warm enough. I get this out quite early and then sit on it. It's the first thing that gets packed away though. I put my chopping board inside this, and that goes right on the back of my camp, of my bag. I camped here, fitting my little tent in there, just quite close to the path. It wasn't a bad slot. Mistake I made, you can see the flap on the left hand side there, because it's not tight enough, and that flapping really makes a noise and keeps you awake. But I've got it packed away, leave no trace. It's a rubbish shop that was left by some other little nasty people. Not seen a soul coming up and down the path, looking down Jacob's Ladder. Can't see anybody at all in the valley even. So on my way back to Edale, I think I'd count that as a successful camp. Certainly the camping part was good. Public transport bit, to be expected really, sadly. I would have liked to have gone via Leeds, but that was cancelled, which is a bit of a bummer. And I think that probably maybe about 3/4 of an hour late, and that 3/4 of an hour would mean I would have got to the top, missed the rain, been able to find a different spot. I think I'd have walked a bit further and got pitched before the rain started, which I just about did yesterday. It was raining when I was finally got pitched into my tent, which meant, well, I'd like to have had a wander around last night, and I wasn't going to do that in the rain. And I would have liked to have cooked my food last night, but I had to wait till this morning. That was a definite success. I'm very pleased with the food part. And I bring the blooming thing out every single time I come camping, but today I've actually had the drone out, which is great. I need to have a lot more practice on that. It's wonderful conditions for flying a drone down this Edale Valley. Dead calm, nobody about. A few trees around, but I think I could probably avoid those if I was to get it out again. But I'm not, I just want to get back to Edale and get back home to see my darling wife and the lovely hounds